Hi, welcome back to The Shtick. We're at the bar with a young lady by the name of Robyn Reynolds. Hello, Robyn.
Hi, Henry. Thank you for having me.
That's okay. Now, you've just driven down from Sydney via Albury.
I have. The rumours are true.
And you got a speeding ticket?
I did get a speeding ticket.
Well, that's funny. This is a comedy show.
Yes, I laughed the whole time. Yeah, I just got a speeding ticket. Absolutely true. I did it. I was rushing here to do telly for the Jews. So
what's your family background? How come you're called Reynolds? Where did
the family
from?
Name was Robyrchek.
Robyrchek?
But it got changed to Reynolds.
A rubber check, it bounced.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And which I understand why they changed it, but Robyn Robyrchek would have been so cool. No.
So cool.
Yeah.
Yeah, it sounds more exotic.
Robyn Robyrchek.
Yeah, I like it. You should change it back.
Yeah, but now everyone knows me as Robyn Reynolds. It's the brand.
Yeah, it's a brand.
Everyone.
You've branded yourself, and you're basically a comedian performer.
Basically.
Yeah?
Yeah.
What do you think about being called a comedian? Does that work for you? Or because it's gone into the past.
I guess I don't really hear it anymore.
No.
Sometimes people just say it for emphasis.
Mm.
If they want to make sure that, you know, everyone knows there's going to be a lady on. They're like, and comedian.
Comedian.
So it's a bit old-fashioned. It's a bit funny.
And you're an award-nominated performer and MC.
Yep.
Yeah, so have you won any awards?
No. Once I win, I'm going to be such a handful. I'm never going to shut up about it. So I've been nominated for Best Comedy 3 times. Yep. I think one of them I was shortlisted. They sent me an email and they let me know that I got right down to the wire and then I just didn't win it. And same, I got shortlisted for a writing award. And so they let you know, they're like, you get nominated first. And then they're like, you've been shortlisted. And you go, okay. And then you don't win. And you're like, all right, I guess I'm still humble.
Didn't you get the Emerging Writer Award?
No, I got shortlisted for
again,
that one.
Another one.
Yeah, exactly.
Oh,
that's what I mean.
Yeah.
That's why I'm still very humble.
And you're still working on it?
Still working on it, still writing.
And you're actually moving to Melbourne?
I am. That was why we drove down and didn't get a nice, relaxing plane with just carry-on luggage that would have been so great. We drove down, there's loads of stuff in the car, and I am moving here, and I'm starting off with a bang with my Fringe show.
Right. Yeah, well, that's why you're here, especially, because we like to promote emerging artists, and you are an emerging artist. I'd never heard of you, I'm sorry.
I'm peeping out. I'm emerging.
It's like, foo, hello, I'm here.
Please promote me.
Yeah, well, we do that on the shtick because I like to do that. You know, like we often get people on, more often than not, we get people on that are notable and noted and have been established. But this week we're going to have people who I want to get their name out there.
Yeah.
Because you deserve it. You've been working very hard at it. What were you doing before comedy?
I was actually briefly a French translator.
Oh, yeah, tu parles français?
Oui, je parle très bien français. Tu parles français?
Oui, oui.
Oh, je peux te tutoyer.
C'est trop difficile. Trop difficile pour moi. Mais nous avons quelque chose à parler, non?
Yeah, non? We do. Sorry, yeah. We're just literally talking in French right now. This
That's
is
okay,
so cool.
We'll have subtitles.
Littéralement well, just français. I can do the sous-titres for you. I can do
it. Oui, nous avons Adobe maintenant. Adobe, c'est très bien. Pour les sous-titres. That's the word. I love French. I'm a Francophile, and I love all things French in art.
Yeah.
And who was in Paris this week? On Facebook, I follow all these friends, and one of my friends was in Paris, Normie Diamond. Hi, Normie. Amazing photos. He went to the Louvre, which was my favourite place of all time to go, and Versailles.
Yeah.
I love all those places. It's just so grand and beautiful. And the art, whatever happened to France, has gone down the tubes. Too many immigrants, but we won't go there.
you know that we're Jewish, right?
Yeah, I know. That's why, seriously, last time I was in Israel, there was more French spoken than Hebrew. Everywhere.
Right.
French people are just leaving in droves from France, coming to Israel because it's safe.
Oh, right.
And it's beautiful. There's a whole French colonies where everyone, tout le monde parle français.
That is really interesting. I didn't know that.
You didn't know that.
But yeah, I've still got friends in France. They love it. I lived in the northwest, which I adore.
In the northwest? What city?
I lived in Nantes.
Nantes? Vraiment.
It's gorgeous.
Yeah,
I love
beautiful.
It.
That's
and no one speaks English, so
it's
you
old
have
world.
To speak French. Yeah.
That's old worldy. And you've done quite a few shows. You started around 4 years ago. You've been doing this?
Pretty much. And COVID hit. So then, like, during the lockdown, I wrote my first hour, which, you know, maybe I should have stayed a baby comedian for a bit longer, carried on doing split bills. But I just had so many stories I wanted to tell. And yeah, that's why I did my first hour relatively early on in my comedy career. I guess I'm still quite early on. Like, people say it takes 10 years to be a really good comedian. So still got a few years ahead of me before I'm really good. But please come and see this show.
Yeah, well, we'll talk about that at the end. Because right now, I just wanted to know a little bit about some of the shows that you've done. You started off as a mermaid.
I did start off as a mermaid. You've done your research.
Yeah, I've worked it all out, I know. And then you did another show called Cake. I like Cake.
Well, Cake was my work in progress show. So that's why I called it Cake, because I love to bake. I'm a baker.
Yeah, you're a baker as well as a French translator.
Oh, well, I love making French cakes.
French cakes?
I love making French cakes. And a crepe, I make like really thin pancakes.
Yeah.
I'm a bit of a Francophile as well, I guess. And yeah, so Cake was my work in progress where I didn't know what it was going to be. So in all the marketing, I said that I was getting the ingredients together and we're going to bake a cake. And then that was actually the one that got shortlisted for those couple of awards.
What's clever?
It was, I think it was.
Did you bring an oven?
No, I wish. I did bake for everyone. I did bake. I baked a lot of cookies and a lot of cakes for my cake run. And yeah, I think that was an evolution of my first show, Mermaid, with all the stories about me and my family. And
where are they from originally? Are they
Russia? I'm Hungary and Czechoslovakia.
Hungary, right. Central Eastern Europe.
Yeah. And then obviously I'm English as well, so there's that background.
Yeah, where were you born?
Gloucester.
I love Gloucester cheese.
Oh wow, so few people have heard of Gloucester.
Well, as an antique dealer, I used to travel all over England.
Of course.
Looking for rubbish.
Yeah, we've got Roman ruins down there.
Yeah, I know. I know, it's beautiful. I've been there.
It is beautiful. There's nothing to do, but
nothing to do. Boring as all hell. But you've also done something that I love, the tragedy of Jewish comedy. That's really what I wanted to talk about.
Yes, I loved that. So I was lucky enough to MC a panel at the Sydney Jewish Writers Festival.
That's right. And that was just recent.
So recent.
Yeah.
The other day, it was in August, and I was lucky enough to meet David Baddiel.
Yeah. He's a big deal, David Baddiel.
He has been on TV my entire life, and then I got to MC with him and ask him loads of questions, and it was wonderful.
Oh, fantastic. Yeah, well, I missed him. For some reason, I was supposed to go and film his shtick at the Classic Cinema. I was told by Bram Presser, thanks, Bram. He said, oh, there's no filming. And then I get another email, like, after the fact that, why didn't you come and film, you know? And so I missed him. I didn't meet him. He was in and out of Melbourne, did a big show in Sydney, I know.
He did several. He was the headline act at the Sydney Jewish Writers Festival.
Yeah, I know.
So loads of the events included him, and he showed his film, his documentary, Jews Don't Count.
Jews Don't Count. Very controversial. Do we count or don't we? Are we in or are we out? You know.
Yeah.
And because we're always in, but at the same time we're often out.
Well, we're always being talked about.
Yeah, but the funny part about being Jewish is the tragedy of it all. You know, because we've had so many centuries and centuries of pogroms, and not to mention the Holocaust and other things that we've had to, you know, discrimination and racism and anti-Semitism and stuff that we've had to cope with, and we still come out on top.
I think we come out laughing. I think that's the main point, is we are always, like, every Jew I know is the funniest person.
Well, the best comedians in the world, I must have to say, you know, without any doubt, are Jews.
And why?
That's what
I talk about in my show a bit.
Because they like to talk a lot.
I think it's the talking, but also there's obviously something that resonates with people who aren't Jewish as well, because Jewish comedy and Jewish comedians are so popular, and I think it is that storytelling and making light out of the dark and being able to find the funny in a really sad situation that everyone universally loves.
Yeah, well, my father famously said to me, and I'll never forget this, and he said the only reason he survived the Holocaust, which he was a sole survivor of, is because of his sense of humour. He just kept his spirit up, you know? And he could tell Yiddish jokes from morning till night. He just loved telling jokes.
That was my dad's dad said almost word for word the same thing.
Yeah. Really? It's insane, isn't it? It's great.
It is. It's insane. Yeah.
And my other famous saying is, every Jew thinks he's a comedian.
Every Jew is a comedian.
No, they think they are. No, they're not. No, they're not that funny.
But what's to say what a comedian is? Like, I couldn't believe how easy it was to start a comedy.
Mm.
I mean, I live in fear that my dad will find out that you can just go to an open mic and perform.
Yeah.
Like, I'm very scared that he'll just find that out and that you can do that. But yeah.
Yeah. And the other thing I wanted to talk to you about is your other show that you did with your partner, Chris.
Oh, yeah.
Date night.
Date night.
Yeah, where you're lying. Are you actually lying down in that photo, or is it standing up with a doona?
Oh, it looks like we're in a bed, but we're actually sat on the floor in someone's house with a duvet.
I could tell. It wasn't a genuine bed thing. I can tell. I've got instinct, you know.
Everyone else thinks I'm very instinctive.
They think I'm what?
No. I said,
no. Tell me. I like to know what.
I said everyone else thinks we're in a bed, but you worked it out.
Yeah, no, I worked it out.
I can tell. They're not in a bed.
And also, the trial by fire.
That was just a trial show.
A what show?
That was just a work in progress show.
And what was it about?
I mean, it was all of my material that I'm now doing in this show.
Ah.
So Cake and Trial by Fire. Trial by Fire I did at Sydney Comedy Festival. Cake I did at Sydney Fringe. But they were both work in progress
shows.
So it's a
mashup.
Yeah, over the past year and a half, I've really been trying to... Well, now I'm going to jinx it.
Consolidate.
Make a perfect cake.
That's what it is. You put the ingredients in and you put it in the oven.
It's kind of a culmination of all of that work and all of that writing. And, of course, you write a five-minute story and then you try it out at several gigs.
Yeah.
And maybe you'll say something off the cuff at one of those gigs and then that becomes a line in the story. So it really does take a long time to write a really good hour show. And hopefully this is it. And people in Melbourne can come and see Run, Robyn Run, which is what the show is now called.
Right. Where'd that start from? Why are you in a hurry?
Am I in a hurry?
Are you in a hurry? I think you are. I think you want to become a good comedian after 5 years, not 10 years.
You want to cut it in half,
you know?
I do really want that.
Yeah.
Maybe there is an element of that in this show because it would have been so much easier to do date night with Chris for Melbourne Fringe, because then the pressure is only on you for sort of half an hour of comedy as opposed to an hour. But I really, really wanted to do this show. I feel like I'm ready to make it really beautiful. And Run, Robyn, Run, the name is... Essentially, it felt like for a lot of my teen years and my 20s, I was trying to run from something, whether it was my mother or the generational trauma of my grandparents. It felt like I was trying to run and like I was maybe scared of becoming my parents.
Right, so you had to run away from all that.
Which I think is really relatable.
It's very relatable. I can fully relate. Yeah, so, and a lot of young people like yourself could relate to that, because we don't want to be like our parents. We want to be a new generation of happening people who are just ruled by their screen.
But then we are filled with the flaws of our parents.
Fall far from the tree, you know,
exactly.
That's it. You know, we like that. So your Fringe Festival is on at the Apothecary.
Yes.
It's difficult to say.
You really struggled with that. That was so funny.
I know. I love that word because I'm, as a retired antique dealer, I love apothecaries because they used to have these amazing jars with labels, you know, the gold labels on them. And where's the apothecary?
Well, it's the Bard's Apothecary.
Yeah.
So it's right by, I am going to butcher this name. There's an Italian restaurant right by. It's either called Pellegrino's or Pellegrini's.
Yeah, Pellegrini's.
Pellegrini's. Okay,
Pellegrini's. Okay, that makes
sense. It's literally
sense.
Right next to there, and it's a gorgeous little bar, and I'm thrilled to be there. I've got a 6-night run from the 9th of October to the 14th of October, I believe.
Yeah, that's what it says. Yeah. At 9:15
p.m.
P.M., sorry.
P.M.
Can you imagine getting
up? Yeah, get it out of the way, then we'll all go to brunch.
Yeah.
No, 9:15 p.m.
Yeah.
The 9th of October. And you can find it online if you just Google Run, Robyn, Run, Melbourne Fringe.
Really?
Yeah, or if you Google Robyn Reynolds comedy. I promise you, I know you hadn't heard of me, but I promise you, if I'll pop up on Google and you'll be able to watch my comedy.
Well, Jeremy had heard of you. He's actually met you.
Oh, yes, the other comedian had heard of me. See, I told you.
See? Oh, my God, huge. Don't let it go to your head, Robyn.
Not until I win an award, Henry.
Yeah, I know. Well, I'll nominate you.
Thank you. I'll nominate you.
I haven't seen you yet, but I will be going to your show. Hopefully I'll film it and we'll have some kind of a record.
Don't film it? Oh, my goodness. No,
really? Why do you mean don't film it? You're not shy.
I might wait till there's a night where it's like sold out. And then
no,
you've
got to have promotional material. That's what it's all about.
Okay, well, Henry is apparently coming to film my show. Please come and sit with Henry near the camera so that you can be like, this is really good.
Yeah.
Because sometimes I'll film something and someone sat near a camera. I filmed a set the other day and this woman sat near where I was filming, and whilst I was on stage, the footage is unusable because she's like, God, I love her top. Where do you think she got her top? Do you think I should ask her where she got the top? And that's all you can hear. You can't hear me doing comedy on stage. You can just hear this woman.
That's ridiculous.
It's so funny.
That is top comedy. Got it?
That's cheesy.
It's so nice to meet you, Robyn.
It was lovely to meet you.
I wish you luck in your Fringe Festival.
Thank you.
Premiere.
Well, apparently I'll see you there.
Yeah, I'll come one night. Okay. And it's so busy at the moment. It's ridiculous.
Okay, I feel like you're waging for a cancellation. You're like, yeah, I'll try and come. I'm actually so busy.
It's true. And coming up next on the show, we've got one more segment with a young lady who didn't ask to be. I invited her on. And her, and I know Claire, her name's Claire Elizabeth D, with D-E-A. And she's a writer-performer, and she's also an expert in mind-body, voice, and spirit integration. So she's a bit of a wizard.
Cool.
Or, whatever, she's a goddess more than anything
else. I want to meet Claire.
Yeah, oh, she's coming in, but you have to wait till a little bit later. And she's also a renowned speaker, coach, singer, and author. So we do get talented people on occasionally.
Yeah.
In fact, everybody I have on has a talent of some sort, because that's what the shtick is all about, getting talented people, promoting them, letting them, you know, come on the show and find out what their shtick is.
No, thank you. This is really lovely, honestly. It's really lovely to be here.
I love your accent, and nous allons parler français après.
Oui, c'est surprenant. Je suis ravie de te rencontrer, vraiment.
Merci bien, ma chérie. So we'll see you after the break with Claire, and it'll be lots of fun, because we've had fun so far, haven't we?
Yeah.
Yeah, we're going to have lunch. Tu veux manger avec nous?
Il faut que je cherche les clés pour mon nouvel appartement.
Oh, d'accord.
Mais merci.
Mon plaisir.
Un autre fois.
Un autre fois.